So I hope everyone had a blessed Thanksgiving. I hope you guys had a chance and an opportunity to share the good news and just to be amongst family members. I think this is one of the important aspects of the holidays is we're amongst our lost family, and this opens up chances for us to share the gospel and to just talk about our faith. And I had a subscriber who did just that thing. He actually had a chance to share his testimony with his family. He was at his father's house, and he had about 20 or 30 relatives there with him. So after they had dinner, they met in the living room and they were just talking, and he mustered up enough courage to, you know, interrupt and share his testimony. Now his email, what he wrote to me in his email was, I shared my testimony with my family during Thanksgiving and everyone was happy for me, but didn't want to hear anything else. They congratulated me, but then they left when I started talking about God. And that's actually the appropriate response when we share the gospel amongst sinners. And Vodi Balcom has a new sermon where he talks about this. And he pretty much proclaims everyone is fine with Jesus until you explain who he is. Now, why is that? That's because it's the 1 Corinthians 1:18. The gospel is foolishness to those who are perishing. Everyone is fine with Jesus as long as Jesus is just the good guy in the sky who's okay with everything. He loves everyone. Okay, but the minute you start defining the attributes of God, what he hates, what he loves, and defining who he is as Lord, that's the problem, okay? And that's an appropriate response. I expect that to happen because that's exactly what happened to me when I shared the gospel with family. People started getting up and walking away. One guy said he had to go upstairs and get a hat. My cousin said she had to go check for something in the car. And before long, you're sitting at the table and it's only like two people. But it started off with 15. And so they start spreading out and getting out of there. And so I titled the video, People Treat Christianity Like a Life Hack. Now, what is a life hack? The definition is a strategy or technique adopted in order to manage one's time and daily activities in a more efficient way. A lot of times you'll see people, when you share your testimony, they'll look at it like, I'm so happy for you. I'm so glad that you found that one thing that makes you so happy. Hey, if that's Christianity, if that's Islam, if that's if you become a Muslim, if that's yoga, whatever it is, whatever you need to find to make you happy, I'm happy for you. And I've had people say that to me. I remember a year after I got saved, I was talking to my mom and she was like, I'm so happy my son is a Christian. I just never thought my son would ever be a Christian. Wow, I'm so happy. And she's just beaming. And then I stopped her and I said, do you understand what you're saying? You're saying, I'm happy my son is going to heaven and I'm going to hell. And that stopped her in her tracks and it made her think. And I was able to share the gospel with her. But she wasn't able to get past the notion that she's wicked. She didn't think she was that bad. And I'm still working on her. So I continue to pray for her. But I just wanted to make this video to point out the fact that lost people treat Christianity as though... Even in this young man's email, he talks about how his aunt asked him after he got to share his testimony that, you know, what do Christians do? I'm trying to lose weight. Do you guys fast? You know, do the Muslims fast? I'm trying to, you know, what do you guys do? And it was like she was asking questions like Christianity was something that you pick up to improve your life. Like you pick up a magazine and it says 5 tips to improve your life. One of them is find a religion. So lost people don't understand the significance of what it means to be dead, spiritually dead, and under the wrath of God. So I hope you guys had a chance to share your testimony, share the gospel, and to love on your family in that way. Thank you for listening.